For so long I carried the weight of my past, crippled by burdens like stones on my back. I thought I had fallen too far from your grace.
Welcome to Recovery Radio, where we have hope for you today.
When I was lost, so searching, you were the ground beneath my feet. When I was a blind man begging, you were the eye so I could see.
Hey, good morning. Welcome to Worldwide Recovery Radio. I'm your host, Mike, this morning, along with my co-host, John, over there. Good morning,
hey,
John.
Good morning, good morning.
Yeah.
It's good to be on the air again.
Beautiful day. Welcome to all our listeners all over the world. Good afternoon, good evening, wherever you may be. A little shout out to Pastor Jared in Africa, doing a lot of amazing things within the recovery world. Wow. God has got him on an incredible mission, so a little shout out to him. In the evening in Africa. So love you and praying for you. A lot of good things going on. Some changes and some beautiful weather here in Havasu. I don't know what it's like where you are. We know that there are many cold places and even warmer places elsewhere. But John, you want to open us up in prayer?
Yeah, sure would. Just bow your heads and hearts where you're at right now. Heavenly Father, just thank you so much for all you've done for us and the blessings you've given us. I pray that you just be with us today, that your words are our words, our words are your words, and that we can reach those out there that are hurting, that need to turn your lives over to you and surrender to you. In name I pray, amen.
Amen. Amen. Surrender to win.
That's
it. I love
you
that. You know what I mean? Back in the cowboy and Indian days when you were outside playing as a kid and you waved the white flag and you lost the battle. This, when you surrender, you win for sure.
Yeah.
So we're excited. Hey, if you'd like to be a sponsor, we have quite a few. We have room for you. We'd love for you to be able to sponsor this show. We're thankful for the Air Team members. Mm-hmm. There are many, many of them, and they actually created this, helped create this studio and this program. And you know, there's such a big need to support KNLB and Alive FM. We're so thankful. We have our own personal sponsors that sponsor this show, John.
Yeah, we sure do. I'd like to send a shout out to Easy Rider Motorcycle Testing, and they're now hiring riders. They're located at 1080 Aviation Drive or by phone 928-706-4553. We also have Printed Havasu, which is now going by the name Havasu Kindness. They're at 2018 McCulloch Boulevard on Main Street. They have Lake Havasu souvenirs and Christian decor, hats, t-shirts, wooden blocks, decals, bags, and more. Remember, kindness spreads joy. And we also have Hilltop Unity Church, just for supporting us in every way they can and also providing our hats and t-shirts, which Mike will talk about here in a minute. And we also have an anonymous sponsor out there. You know who you are. God knows who you are. Thank you so much for all you do in keeping us on the air.
Yeah, amen. Hey, you know, this is a live call-in show. And if you call in, you enter a drawing, and our special guest today, Miss Patty, is going to pull from our drawing, and you may win a T-shirt or a hat, a Recovery Radio T-shirt or a hat. So it's either of your choices. So it's a nice gift just for calling in. Let me tell you a little bit about what we're about. Recovery Radio is here for you. It's a program about you, praying for you, talking about different subjects, topics. We've had over 80 guests here, and just amazing life stories, life changes. So many interesting topics that it's amazing. And again, what God can do in someone's life through a tragedy or a hurt or some kind of struggle. It's just amazing to watch. So it really is a program for you and about you. We're here to support you in any way and hopefully bring something to the table that you can identify with.
Exactly.
And I'll tell you, our resources are amazing.
Yes, they are.
If you go to RecoveryRadioLHC.com, you'll be able to look up everything. We've got so much information. We spent a long time on that website and we'll updated all the time, right, John?
Yes.
We've got a ton of stuff on
there. I've got a bunch of things that I need to add to the site for resources.
Yeah.
I've been lazy.
Yeah, it's okay. It's okay.
I haven't gotten there yet.
Next week's show, we're going to have John on as guest, and we're going to talk about laziness.
Procrastination.
Yes. Okay. John, so we're going to sign
Hold
you.
Hold on. I want to do the biblical thing, and I want to point the finger. I was going to do it last week, but the show didn't get recorded, and since I didn't get on the computer at all to do anything with the show to get it live streamed and get it up on YouTube and, you know, streaming it, it was the computer's fault here at KNLB. It just stopped the whole works.
Okay, so
isn't that how we do that? You point the finger. She made me do it. He made me do it. You know,
it goes back thousands of years.
It does.
And it continues in this studio. And we call that excuses.
There you go. Yeah. Hey, so what we're not here to do,
point
obviously, is point the finger. Yeah. Is we are not here to fix anybody. We don't have that kind of power or that knowledge or ability. Only Jesus Christ can fix you. He is the only one that we turn to for any type of healing and for correcting our sinful ways. And also, we're here to come together, you know, as the Bible states, you know, we're to come together and share each other's burdens and encourage one another and lift each other in prayer. And that's what we're here for, to lift each other up and guide each other.
Amen. If you're trying to get us on live stream, we are having some difficulties with the live stream. I just got sent a text, and we apologize. Mm-hmm. We'll try and figure it out.
Yeah.
You'll have to just listen to the audio version.
That's it.
They won't be able to see my beautiful face today.
I just,
people are going to they're gonna complain.
That wonderful I know face they are. Made
Although
for
my
radio,
pastor says I have the perfect face for radio. Yeah, I'll just leave it at that.
Oh,
so listen, 1-800-721-9313. And the local number, 928-855-9110. We would love to hear from you today. Mm-hmm. Our special guest is Patty. And we are going to be talking about food issues. Mm-hmm. And so all of us in the room, we love our food, many different varieties and kinds. And so we'll be talking about that.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, and we have a scripture for
today. We sure do have a scripture.
This is a different kind of food, but it's still all good the same. So we're looking at John 6:35. Then Jesus declared, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never go hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty." Now that, of course, is a different type of food.
Exactly. It is the spiritual food which we need desperately within the world, for sure.
Yeah.
And you just look around and some of the chaos and the panic and the dial changing, the less God, more of self, and the moral compass is gone a different direction, and the respect and the kindness and the love of people is beginning to change an awful lot. And you look around even in the supermarket, you know. Mm-hmm. And I'll tell you, I think such a big factor is the mask. The emotional lackluster kind of, you don't see people smile, you know, because you can't really see the smile.
Yeah.
So it's a little bit challenging. I think people are kind of a little claustrophobic over this whole thing, and it's affecting just millions and millions and millions of people and their lifestyle. So, you know, we've changed the clock a little bit, and we know the answer. The answer is Jesus Christ.
Exactly.
Period. Amen. Right? We know that. Hey, a little shout out to the gang in Bullhead.
Mm-hmm.
We want to say thank you. They host us on a Friday night out there, and John, they're a great bunch of people.
Oh, they are.
And we're really thankful for them. Thank you, guys.
Gosh, it was a wonderful evening last night.
We love you.
Very powerful,
and we really thank you for your for your kindness. Also, Aaron and the boys. Mm-hmm. Hey, doing a shout out, praying for you guys. Amazing things. Listen, just because you're in a place of lack of freedom per se, you are still free within the boundaries of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And so I know Aaron's doing a lot of work for with the men there, and just amazing things. Listen, if no matter where you are, Jesus Christ is right there.
Yep.
You know, and he's with you. Yeah. And if you're led by their spirit, man, amazing things. So praying for you guys, thinking about you all the time. Mm-hmm. You know, we're so thankful, John, for our listeners. We get emails and texts all the time. And you know, Terry answers them. If you need a prayer request, we pray all week for you. They go into our website, and we as a team pray for you. Pat is a prayer warrior, our producer. She's just amazing. We really have a really good team. There's about 10 or 12 of us, and it's amazing. God answers prayers. So, you know, if you want to be a guest and you're going to come through Arizona, put that down, and our producer Pat will get a hold of you, we'll see if we can work that out.
Definitely.
Absolutely.
That would be awesome.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, let's introduce our guest this morning. Although her beautiful face isn't going to be all over the world, we'll be able to hear her
hey, I'll laugh. I'll put her picture up on our webpage.
It will be. You know, good morning, Patty.
Good morning.
You know, Patty, I've known Patty for a few years now, and you know, she's a joy because she's one of those that can sing, and I won't say there's some jealousy there, but I try and sing. And
there's jealousy.
Yes, there is. You know, always wanted to be a rock star up on stage. I don't play any instruments, and I certainly cannot sing. But I love it, right?
Joyful noise. But you have the hair for it. You do have the hair for it.
I do.
As a rock man.
I really do.
Rock star.
Yeah, I got the rock star hair. Yeah, okay.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. From the 60s and 70s. They used to be there.
It'll grow back.
Yes. Yeah. Keep
someday.
Someday.
Yeah. Someday. Yeah. Well, Patty, good morning to you.
Good morning, I'm glad to be here. Thank you for asking me.
Thanks for coming today. I gave you short notice.
Very short.
You know, just this week, and God gave us this topic, and you were right there. So no coincidence, because. This fits your
wheelhouse.
I like that.
There you
go.
Wheelhouse.
That's really good. I kind of need to hear it a little bit today too. So this is really good. We're talking about food issues and consumption and challenges and what do you, Patty? What do you think in today's world right now, beginning of 2021? What do you think the past year has been the biggest challenge for people that are struggling with their weight?
Well, I think a lot of it's due to being inside the house, not getting out and being with people, socializing, watching TV, all the commercials.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
They're nothing but fast food. But I also think this was a good year for people that, you know, we're not outside eating, going to restaurants. So we have control of what we bring into our home when we go shopping. So, you know, like ice cream, for instance.
Oh, my favorite.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There we go.
Mine too. I had ice cream, a big old bowl every night, no matter how full I was. Mm. And
My grandfather used to say it just slides down between the cracks. So it's okay.
It just fills
up.
It just fills
up.
It just fills in the cracks.
Yeah. And it does.
It does.
It does. Mentally too. Because it is something that, you know, everybody enjoys. I don't know anybody that doesn't like ice cream. So September of 2016, I made a choice not to have ice cream in my home anymore. So I have not had ice cream in my home. But I have had ice cream I go out and I buy an ice cream cone. And then I'm satisfied with it. And of course, and sometimes I think, gosh, that ice cream cone cost me like $6. Oh, so yeah. I could have bought two, you know, half gallons for that on sale.
But or a 5-quart pail.
Exactly.
That's where my mind is.
There you go. That's it.
Get the big one, you know?
Yeah, don't get those small ones.
No.
Yeah.
So I think that has helped me a lot by what I bring into my home. You know, of course, my husband has to have, well, which I don't think he has to have, because I don't think anybody has to have unhealthy foods.
No.
But, you know, I do allow a couple of things that he enjoys, and he doesn't have a weight problem. So, you know, thank God, honestly, that they're not my food to go, you know, to go to.
Yeah,
so great. That helps.
Yeah.
You
now,
know,
now during the, you know, this pandemic, drive-through restaurants, fast food chains stayed open because they're drive-through. And I think that probably added a little bit of,
weight around the middle.
It helped. It helped because people could get some food. But I think it also may have created for many a new habit. Because, I mean, that
very
stuff
much
can
so.
Be.
Well, not only that, but all the food delivery, the food delivery services, too. All the fast food restaurants are doing delivery.
Grubhub.
Yeah, you don't have to go anywhere. You just sit at your house and pick up the phone
DoorDash.
And call, and your food shows up.
See, one thing about this is because I'm old, so I don't know how to use all that stuff. So I don't use delivery. I don't even know how to do it.
You're not old.
Well, I'm not. I mean, what I'm saying is that I'm not that, you know, hey, I can pick up
that
and
hip
do.
Generation.
What is it? Dashboard? What is it? I don't know.
DoorDash.
Dashboard.
I don't even know it.
Dashboard, that's in the car.
Oh, that's it.
But you got to get in the car.
I just don't look them up.
I knew that was a car hop one time in my life.
I hear about them, but I don't look them up, because if I look them up, I'll start using them, and that is not a good combination.
No.
So, and they have huge offers.
I mean, you get
that's why free deliveries, or it only costs $1. I mean, they're just throwing that at you all the time.
So that's created a lack of, I mean, let's think about
self-control.
Self-control.
You pick up the phone, and you dial in an order, and 20 minutes later, it's at your door. So you've not moved a muscle at all.
Right.
And I think...
and you take in 10,000 calories.
Right. That's right.
You know, and you probably didn't even get up.
Right.
No.
Well, you had to answer the door.
Yeah.
That is exercise.
Yeah.
Let's talk about it.
Or you had one of your kids do it.
Or you had one of your kids. There you go.
And then you sit in front of the television
TV.
And you consume that and... you know, which creates more of a problem because lack of exercise.
That's right.
Yeah.
And it just sits there and it gathers and gathers. And, you know, I hear the gonna do's. Well, yeah, I'm going to get a treadmill. I'm going to, you know, get out and walk, because don't forget, now, you can, I don't care where you are, you can get out of your house with or without a mask and walk around the block.
That's right.
I mean, we can do it. But sometimes, although... There are so many factors for people putting weight on. I know my wife showed me a picture of her when we first started dating, because I didn't believe her. She said, "Well, at one time I was 205 pounds," and I was like, "She's a skinny little thing," and I'm like, "No way in the world." And she showed me a picture, and it was, you know, people get caught up in a very stressful marriage relationship. And control and on, and you are so stressed out that people turn to different things. Some booze, you know, got to have a little drink just to settle me down and settle my nerves and calm my nerves. And other people, comfort food. And she did a lot of that. And so she had to work real hard to get back down to the 130 pounds. So, you know, it's... It's a fact that just like anything else, you know, people will say, I've got food issues. Why? Just stop eating.
It's just easier said than done.
Yeah,
and
definitely.
You have to eat.
Well, it's just like an alcoholic,
that's
too.
That's right.
But
that's right.
You know, you don't need
just
the alcohol.
Stop drinking.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But
stop
it's still
eating.
Hard.
You just can't. You just
and
can't
everything's,
do it.
Everything, think about it. where we go and we socialize. Mm-hmm. Where are we? We're eating.
Yep.
We cannot go to somebody's house without having a spread.
Yeah.
And then where do we stand? Right in front of the spread.
Yep.
And what are we doing while we're talking?
Grazing.
We're putting it in our mouths.
Yeah.
We have to be mindful of mm-hmm. what we are putting mm-hmm. in our mouths.
Mm-hmm.
If you're going to, I don't say restrict yourself. What I do say, though, is if it's something like ice cream mm-hmm. is my, you know, calling my name in the refrigerator, mm-hmm. freezer, yeah. so I don't have it. But I still have it when I go out to get it.
Right.
So don't restrict yourself, because once you start restricting yourself, mm-hmm. once you get off those fad diets,
yeah, exactly.
then you're eating everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if you continue with a healthy, you know, and it takes probably 3 weeks to mm-hmm. really get in the groove yeah. of eating healthy.
Mm-hmm.
And I say take one day of the week, whatever day you feel mm-hmm. comfortable and that you have time with, and take about an hour,
yeah.
turn music on and dance
there you go.
While you're prepping food for the week.
Mm.
And have it all set up in your refrigerator
mm-hmm.
or in your wherever, you know, your mm-hmm. your pantry.
Yeah.
And another thing about pantries, put your stuff that you that is easy for you to grab and it's not too good for you.
Mm-hmm.
Put it way up. It's not easy to grab.
Right.
And if you're prepping with your vegetables, that's easy. Just take them out and, you know, yeah. have them in baggies, whatever you want to do.
Yeah.
You know, have your spouse with you. Mm-hmm. Make it a fun time, though.
Yeah.
Because you know how when you're making salads, it takes a long time to make a salad?
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
It's labor.
Mm-hmm.
It's, you know, a couple months ago, or maybe longer. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Time goes by so fast.
It does.
Could have been 2 years ago. I don't know.
Yeah.
Honestly, I was doing my salad, and I was chopping everything up, and I'm enjoying, I'm praying, and just, you know.
Singing,
yeah. and just, you know, having yeah. a good time with myself, by myself. And I looked down, and I saw this beautiful salad that I made. And you know the joy that brought me? Because it wasn't cheese and crackers.
Mm-hmm.
It was something really healthy for
yeah.
me.
Mm-hmm.
And it really made me feel good that I am on that path of eating healthy.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's sometimes that, you know, I don't have
mm-hmm.
the, because carbs also, okay, I
yeah.
confess.
Carbs are awesome.
Oh my gosh, I get in front of this mic and I'm confessing everything.
Well, that's because God tells you to tell the truth.
Okay, I do have a problem.
And you thought this would be a fun show.
It's going to be fun.
Yeah.
It's going to be really easy. I could tell people what to do.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, carbs. So that is, you know, and I think a lot of people, I mean, who doesn't like rice?
Mm. Pasta.
Freshly baked bread.
Yum, 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 yum.
Yeah, we just had baked ziti last night with nice fresh cheese and rolls.
Yes,
and
some Hawaiian rolls.
You know. So, but I.
Okay, all right, let's get back to it.
Let's get back to this. Moderation.
I had a nice
little piece.
That's right.
And then I had a delicious salad along with it and a water and a little piece of dessert, which is, I'll tell you, not normal for me.
It's difficult.
Not normal, you know, portions.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And sometimes I definitely, because it's so darn good. And here's another thing that I think it's critical to, you know, get out and at least go shopping. Make a healthy list.
Yeah.
And I tend to stray from that because I'll see a, and here's one of the problems is I'll see a sale on ice cream.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And if you, I mean, it's a good deal.
Yeah.
And,
yeah, exactly.
And
yeah.
if you buy four or five,
that's right.
you get another dollar off of that gallon on top of that. And I'm thinking, man, boy, that's a great deal.
Oh,
and now I've got five half gallons of ice cream in the two freezers, one inside and then one outside.
Is it worth it? Is it really? I mean, maybe for the money. It is,
yeah.
but for your brain, what you're thinking about yourself.
Yeah, yeah I absolutely agree because what I'll do is I'll get into the mode of, I'll have a little dish of ice cream and I have that every night until it's almost gone. And I'll have to mentally say, okay, you've had ice cream for the past week.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Take some time off.
Right.
And I think about it, and I go and get that
ice cream.
Mm-hmm. Ice cream. because I have it.
Okay.
So,
well, let me give you a suggestion here. Mm-hmm. You know that now all the stores... I believe all the stores, I know Smith's does, and I've used it, is they do the shopping for me.
Mm-hmm.
So I make the list. So I'm not inside because I'm the same way.
Yeah.
I'll go down and that will make you stick with what you've got.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Exactly.
But if you see me, I spend most of my time in the produce department.
Mm-hmm.
The fresh, fruits and vegetables. Yeah. That's the first place. Of course, you know where I have to pass.
Yeah,
the bakery.
All the bread and
all the bakery. Always,
the deli and all of that.
Well, things are designed on purpose,
sure,
you know,
is.
And we have to remember that. How many times we don't even pay attention, but there it is, right in front of us, in a
and it's
place.
In our basket. The next thing you know, it's in our basket.
And if you look,
they
put the produce all the way in the back corner of a store.
That's good exercise,
and
though.
It is good exercise.
Look at it that
you
way.
Have to have some discipline, all fresh rolls or this.
Yeah.
Or
cakes, like pies.
I need a little breakfast for the morning, so I'll get a package of the cupcakes. Not cupcakes. Like blueberry cupcakes and stuff
muffins.
Like that.
They're called muffins.
Yes, thank you.
And they also give you muffin tops.
Yeah.
Just saying.
Oh,
yeah. Just saying, muffin tops.
Oh, boy.
But, hey, if you love to talk to Patty or one of us, our number is 1-800-721-9313, local number 928-855-9110. Shout out to Rachel in Pioneer, California. Hey. Thank you, Rachel. Loves the show. Sent in a text, man. We thank you for your loyalty and listening today.
Now, Patty, you were talking. Okay, you know, we're talking about all these different foods, and you talked about that portion control is the number one issue.
Yes,
you know, it's like usually you'll get a frozen pizza, which isn't good anyway. But if you get a frozen pizza, I can put a frozen pizza in the oven and I'll eat the whole pizza in one sitting.
Mm-hmm.
Very easy to do.
Sure.
But then you look at the portion control, and the portion control is like 1/16th of the pizza.
Right.
And you're like, really? And that's one of the biggest issues I have is with my wife. She manages my portions for me because I have no control.
Mm-hmm.
And I've even prayed about this, and it's a battle for me. It's really hard when it comes to food. I have a hard time with that portion control.
Mm-hmm.
And she'll put a portion, giving me the plate, and it's just, I look at it, and it's just like, that's it? That's all I get? And it's just really, really hard. It's a mental thing to be able to see that and to know that that's all your body needs and don't give it any more than that.
Right.
So how could you give us any advice on how to manage portion control and how to get over that hurdle? You talked about some things earlier.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, one good way is to use a salad plate instead of a big dinner plate.
Oh, yeah.
And because it's smaller, and when you put your food on there, and I've done this myself, is I cut everything up so that it makes it look like there's a lot more to.
Uh-huh. Yeah, okay.
And so
tricking your brain,
exactly.
Okay.
So that's one way of doing it, and save a snack like a nice piece of fruit for later in the evening. So when you start kind of feeling a little bit, and drink lots of water. Lots of water.
That's a difficult one for me too. Is drinking a lot of water.
A lot of people, and I don't get it because I'm a water-aholic.
Uh-huh.
I love water, and try putting stuff in it like cucumbers or strawberry. Somebody said something else. I can't remember now what it was.
Lemons.
I put coffee in.
That's it.
I put coffee in my water.
You know what, that's a good one too.
And you know what it is
with
me?
Do you put cream in it?
It's not so much.
I do, and honey.
So
my water is all dolled.
You can take that out on a date.
My biggest issue with water is not so much the drinking it.
Uh-huh.
It's just the constant having to run to the restroom.
But that's exercise.
It's constant exercise. I'll drink a bottle of water and have to run to the bathroom like three times for one bottle of water.
Okay, maybe
like,
you ought to go to the doctor. There might be something wrong.
That's a whole nother show.
Oh, that's a different show. Okay.
Yeah, that's a different show.
Let's go on about that one.
All right.
But do you think that is a good idea? I mean, do you think portion control?
Yeah, definitely. The smaller plates, because I know a lot of our plates, you have these huge plates and you feel like you got to fill it up.
Yeah.
you know, and you end up going way over.
Same way with buffets.
Yeah.
Have you ever gone to a buffet and just had...
Well, you got to get your money's worth.
You got to get your money's worth.
You paid for it, but you're going to make sure you get it.
But the problem is, we'll go to a restaurant and pay like $35 for a dinner, and you only get one plate.
Yeah.
But you'll go to a buffet for $10, and you got to eat $10 worth of food.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
crazy.
Well, you know, the other thing, too, the $35 meal, though,
yeah.
is usually like three portions.
Well, yes.
It really is. When you go to a restaurant and you order a plate, you know, it usually is two to three portions on that one plate per serving. And it's kind of one of the things we try to get in the habit of doing. Sometimes it's hard to do. But we'll go and we'll figure out what we want, and we'll order one plate and we'll split it.
Well, you know, another thing you can do, too, because I'm big on when I used to work, everybody used to joke, oh, you went out to dinner, because I always brought leftovers.
Yeah.
And I wasn't a big eater, you know, for restaurants.
Right.
So I would just ask for a doggy bag.
Yes, that's right another good strategy.
You know, really strategy. And you can do that even when you order it. Mm-hmm. And don't be afraid to tell people, you know, the waitress, I don't want butter on my vegetables. Mm. Cook it without butter, you know, or cook it without sauce. Sauce is one of the worst things that you can have. If it says creamy, yum, 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 not good. Yeah. Fattening, fattening, fattening.
Patty, what about, you know, I know it's easy for us. We seem to at least be able to get around, to be able to get in the car and drive to the store and walk the store, walk up and down the aisles. And obviously, you know, you'll have a list and everything else. But yeah. there are a lot of people who have physical ailments, you know, bum knee or, you know, a back issue or back problem and stuff like that. And maybe they tend to be a lot less active because of that. And they found that they've kind of put on some weight because of the less activity. What's your suggestion to help them in a way to make some changes?
Well, that's really important to start eating healthy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, and not layer all your stuff with carbs on your plate, you know, and to have, you don't have to just have salad. I mean, there's a lot of great vegetables out there. I kind of got burnt out on salads for a while because I was using it. I mean, I've been doing this since I joined Weight Watchers back in 1986. And the reason why I wanted to do it is I wanted to lose some weight to go on a cruise with my husband and my daughter. And I think I was the first one ever that actually lost a pound in that week's cruise.
Oh, wow.
Because I had my husband. We walked that whole ship.
Oh, yeah.
And I just was determined because I was going back to that Weight Watchers meeting. And I wanted everybody to know that I didn't gain any weight because I had just reached my goal.
Yeah.
So you have to have goals, you know, too. You know, like if you, let's say you've got 20 pounds to lose. Halfway through, have a goal and do not reward yourself with food.
Oh, gosh.
Oh,
I do that.
What do we do?
Yeah. Hey, well, I'll celebrate.
Ooh, I'm going to have celebrate. Sunday with bananas. Yeah. And exactly. Man, I've done good.
Gosh. Exactly.
Yeah.
You know, it.
Have a banana split.
I can equate that to my drinking and drug days.
Yeah.
And I would do good for a while. And I'm like, see, I've done amazing for 6 months. This is fantastic. And I go out for a weekend and just ruin it all.
Right.
Yeah. And,
same thing with food. You
do that. Reward yourself with something that you want to do, something that you would not normally go out and buy or give something to somebody else. Give your time to somebody else that you don't feel you have time. Something that's going to make you feel good. You know, and don't feel guilty. The whole thing about eating healthy, I think, is... You know, once you get into that rabbit hole of guilt, it closes in. And then what happens? You know, if you blow it, let's say you blow it, and you know, like you eat too much of something or whatever, you know, the next meal, whatever that next meal is, get back on track.
Yeah.
Because that's the only way you're going to do it. If you go, oh, well, tomorrow I'll start all over again. Well, tomorrow you get up and you're feeling, you know what? I'm okay. Yeah. I can eat whatever I want.
Exactly.
You know, and we can, realistically, we pretty much can eat what we want if we do portion control, exercise. But I'm saying, you know, when I did Weight Watchers in 1986, for the first year, nothing passed these lips that wasn't Weight Watchers safe. And trust me, back in 1986, Weight Watchers was hard to follow. Mm. Not like it is now.
Yeah.
So that kind of taught me, you know. And then when I retired here 18 years ago, it was all about, oh, I have time to bake. Never baked.
Oh,
never.
Boy. Yeah.
And I ate potato chips with a sandwich. I hadn't done that in probably 15-20 years.
I do that all the time.
But I eat the whole bag. It's not just a couple chips. It's like, give
me
the bag.
You get a little handful, put it on the plate, and you're halfway done with your sandwich. Mm.
Yeah.
And
you
all
need
the chips are gone, so you get another handful.
There you go.
Now, what are chips good for?
Nothing.
Dip. Honestly.
Dip.
They are, what's dip good
they
for?
They are delicious.
Chips.
Chips. No, but you know what I'm saying is that's what I mean. You know, we get into a habit of eating just stuff that's not good for us. Mm-hmm. What does a donut do? Only gives you comfort. Why does it give you comfort? Why can't something else give you comfort? Why does it have
it
to be food?
Because it doesn't taste as good.
Yeah. But it can. You know, it really can. When you start eating really healthy, you start feeling good about
yourself. Your taste buds change.
Yeah. Definitely.
It's really incredible.
Yeah.
When I was a lot younger, I was an athlete. I played football for like 20 years.
Uh-huh.
And I hardly ever had sweets. I still to this day don't really care for dessert. I mean, I'll eat my ice cream.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
But I had one bowl of ice cream in the last, I think, like 4 months.
Good for you.
That's good.
I just don't eat it, but I do buy it for the house, you know, because I have kids and you know they like their ice cream. But it wasn't something that, you know, that I had when I was younger. I mean, I was more of give me the food, you know, kind of eater. Yeah. I want the meal. I don't really care about dessert, you know, because I prefer my steak and potatoes and, you know, and all the, and even the vegetables. I mean, I love vegetables.
Good.
Yeah.
Problem is I get in my recliner now, you know, those 20 years of football, I have the back issues, the shoulders, the knees, the ankles, everything's gone. I can't stand very long. I have a bad heart. I've had 2 heart attacks. I take, John's seen my my pill box. You know, I take about 18 pills a day just to keep my heart going. So I don't have the energy because I have like 30% of my heart that works. So how can I, a former athlete who's used to running 5 miles a day without breaking a sweat hardly, and playing football and all of that, go now, you know, 20 years later, have had 2 heart attacks and don't have the finances to eat healthy when you have a large family like I do?
See, you know what? Years ago, I found out that a lot of these grocery stores, if they were in a poor neighborhood, didn't have fruits and vegetables because they couldn't afford it.
Yeah.
And that's why we have so many overweight people that can't afford eating good and healthy. It's a tragedy. I mean... Do you eat, first off, cut your portions. I think that's a big thing. And
because I'm with John. I can eat a whole pizza.
Definitely cut your portions.
Yes.
You know, and children, I have this thing. My daughter came up to me years ago, and she's like skinny, 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 and she's, I hate to say this, but she's going to be 50 in August. She told me, she goes, Mom, you know, every time I had to go and get anything for that was good, like cakes and all that stuff, was I'd have to go to my friend's house because we never had it. And I go, well, you can thank me. Yeah. You do not have a weight problem.
Yeah.
Okay. So I don't believe that children need to have all the stuff that we bring into the house.
Right. Soda's a bad one.
Soda's a huge
Because you talk about the importance of water.
Water.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Water. And my kids drink water like all day long.
Yeah. So if you substituted some of the stuff like chips and lunch meat's another, you know, I mean, anything. Mm. I mean, okay, this is what I tell my girls is that eat as close to the ground as possible. Mm-hmm. And I don't mean picnic style. Mm-hmm. I mean health, good stuff that's not packaged.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I go in to get like some beans and that kind of stuff, but I do my shopping usually, you know, to the dairy department and to the meat department and the vegetables, mm-hmm. the fresh vegetables.
Stay around the outside.
Stay on the outside.
Stay out of the aisles.
But they do still have, you know, you could still have canned vegetables. You can have frozen mm-hmm. vegetables. Mm-hmm. I remember when WW just started with peas and corn. You could have peas and corn. Mm. Well, years ago, you know, you could never have peas and corn, especially with a carb.
Yeah.
And my husband would always, I mean, we've been married 50 plus years. And I'd go, what do you want to eat? And he goes, well, can we have like, mashed potatoes and corn? Mm-hmm. I go, can't.
Two starches. Oh,
you
no.
No, we can't have that. What are you talking
Rule
about?
Rule breaker at dinner.
Yeah, there you go.
I'm thinking with a little butter. A little
there you go. It sounds good to me.
Gravy. I mean, you know, mashed potatoes.
I usually mix the
gravy.
Corn into the, into the potato.
Yeah, same here.
All right. So that's
little cheese.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. You guys are horrible.
Yes, we are. We are.
We're men.
Yeah, yes. Exactly. Yeah.
Patty, what about now? Here's another sidebar. And Bill, that's probably a really good example that you talked about. People get into a rut, mm-hmm. and they all of a sudden put 20 pounds on that they didn't have in their life.
In fact, I did put 20 pounds on this last year,
and it causes some physical ailments and problems. I know my middle brother has tried to fight the bounce back and the yo-yo effect. And, and it really all comes down to eating, and he's more of a picky eater, and he's got diabetes now, so he fights that.
Yeah.
And, a lot of people through food develop physical ailments and mm-hmm. challenges. Your remedy for that, exercise, and again back to the portions.
Yes, mm-hmm. and try your best. I mean, get an accountability partner, mm-hmm. which is always good too, because mm-hmm. You want to make sure that you're on the same page also with that person that can mm-hmm. say, like, if you're, you know, oh gosh, I got to have a hot dog, you know, and you can call that person and say, I'm really needing a hot dog right now. And she can talk or he can talk you off the ledge.
Yeah.
You know, like all that stuff, when you think about all the stuff that's all processed, it might not cost that much, but if you eliminate that from mm-hmm. your diet, you're going to have more money to spend on, you know,
The healthier stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know what else to say. A pool, if you have a pool, that's always good for your mm-hmm. joints. I mean, it's not as hard. Yeah. Even if you can just get up at every commercial, don't watch it. Get up and just walk
around. We haven't had that kind of TV in our house in over a decade.
Oh,
so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
We don't
exercise
have cable or anything.
Is a big key.
Yeah.
It really is. Just walking outside, walk around the house, get back in, and sit down. You do that a few times a day. I think that's probably one
just
of
get
the
up and move.
Ones.
Just get up and get up and move.
Movement. Yeah. I love the accountability. There's all kinds of programs. We'll add some information to our website also. Our phone number 1-800-721-9313 and the local number 928-855-9110. I know the phone lines have been lighting up. I think I think Patty, no one's brave enough to get on the air. So Pat will have a whole a list of people that we're praying for and do shout outs to, but we'd love to hear from you and some of the things that you've been through, maybe some of the victories, maybe some of the struggles you're going through currently, and maybe Patty can give you some advice or some guidance. You know what? I think how many times do we try and do things on our own?
Mm-hmm.
And we fight it and we fight it. And mm-hmm. I know I did with, you know, with my addiction, the drinking and the drugging, and it's really the same thing. Going to meetings, getting up, getting in your car, or even if you don't drive and you could use, you know, we use lots of different excuses.
Right.
Then, you know, call somebody. Say, hey, listen, I could use a ride. I'm going to this program. People are going to come alongside, and they're going to help you, and they're going to support you in getting to a meeting. People are going to help you, guide you, love you for who you are, and pray for you. Mm-hmm. And that's a big help. The isolation has been, I think, a big problem in so many different ways. And this is just one facet that that has really hurt us, I think, not only all over the world, but seem to be a bigger nation, you know, as far as weight than many others.
Yes.
And
well, you know what? Okay, let me. Another thing is, when you go to the grocery store, there is so much to choose from. Mm-hmm. I remember growing up, and they maybe had like five different salad dressings.
Mm-hmm.
You go down there now, and there's about an aisle of them.
Yeah. Well, that's crazy. Say, go back to ice cream. It was vanilla, chocolate, and strawberry.
And Neapolitan. Well,
which one you want? Neapolitan. And Neapolitan had a piece of all three.
Right.
You know, and I say that now in Baskin Robbins, it takes you 20 minutes
to figure out
to
what you want.
Try and decide what flavor you might want.
Yeah.
So
we've got too much.
We have a lot.
We have a lot of decisions to make.
And I think another thing that is also changed in society, because we live in a microwave society.
Oh, yeah. Right.
We are. Mm-hmm. We get information in 4 seconds right now.
Instant gratification.
We don't spend the time in the kitchen to. You know, I said to my wife today, I said, I think maybe I'll make another pot of my homemade chicken vegetable soup.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I mean, it takes all day. You got to work at it, and then it slow cooks all night. But I've got a great big pot of that. Mm-hmm. And what I do is I freeze it in portions mm-hmm. for her and I. Mm-hmm. And we'll pull one of those out, and we have a great big bowl of soup. So you can do that also. There's lots of different ways, but take time, because you're worth it.
That's right.
We hurry up, and you know, and you don't understand. I got the two kids, and on, and I get that. Yeah. So it can be very, very challenging.
Yeah. Hey, we have a caller on line three. We have Bonnie on the line. Hey, good morning,
buddy.
Good morning, buddy. Welcome to Recovery Radio.
Thank you. I love Celebrate Recovery. I don't attend as much as I should, but I still love Celebrate Recovery, just
Amen.
So you know.
Amen. Yeah.
That I believe that I've used your tools to help change my life completely and forever.
Mm. Yeah.
And the reason I'm calling is because I didn't hear the whole morning message today. But I heard a question about, somebody said they had a question regarding what to do when you have limited mobility.
Mm-hmm,
and
yes.
Okay, well, I can totally relate to that right now.
Yeah, you can.
Mm-hmm.
So I used to be 400 pounds several times in my life. Actually, I can admit to being 400 pounds. It took me a whole year to realize that I was 400 pounds more than once.
Mm-hmm.
And then almost four years ago, in March, God worked a miracle on my brain and my soul and my heart, and completely changed my mindset toward eating.
Mm-hmm.
And I've gotten rid of over 200 pounds.
Oh, wow. We're going to ring the bell on that.
Wow, that's fantastic.
Wow. Congratulations, Bonnie.
But in October, this past October, I got sick and ended up with, I've been diagnosed with Guillain-Barré syndrome, which is a disease that steals your nervous system. And I cannot walk, and I'm in a wheelchair, and I've been, I'm home now for the last 2 weeks, but for 2 months. I was in a hospital or a recovery, rehab hospital or a nursing home. My mindset is such that I refuse to eat any of the beautiful junk food that they had available.
Fantastic.
They said, you can eat whatever you want. It's on the menu, Bonnie. Eat it. You want to eat lasagna? Eat it. You want to eat spaghetti? Eat it. And I said, no. I'm not going back to 400 pounds. I am not.
Excellent. Amen. Amen.
I'm home, and I'm still not eating junk.
Good for you. Amen.
Good job. You know, it takes that. It takes, Patty, it takes, just like anything else, you can hear it in Bonnie, it takes discipline.
That's right.
With anything else. It's like, for me, I need to make sure that I stay out of the bars. I don't need to go down the liquor aisle or section in a grocery store. You know, people say, well, it's always there. Well, okay, don't go down that aisle.
Don't go down the aisle.
Avoid it. And
they have it separated. You don't need to be there.
It becomes easier and easier. And I think,
well, she's taking her power back.
Well, I like that.
Over the food. You're taking the power back. So that's fantastic.
Which will only help your body, Bonnie, as you've obviously experienced going through a very difficult time, you will be able to, in a way, continue to exercise. Now, if you gave in to all of that, that would have obviously created a whole nother backslide and a physical problem within you.
That's right.
And here's a really important thing people forget when it comes to poor people with food addiction. And this is a real struggle, and I don't know if you've already discussed it, but food addiction, I don't believe you just get to walk away from, like, you can walk away from drugs, you can walk away from cigarettes, you can walk away from alcohol. You have to eat every single day.
Yeah, exactly.
You have to.
You have to eat, but you also have to keep in mind that you need to put, you're fueling your body.
Exactly.
You know, you're not here to eat to, what is that saying about eat to live or...
Yeah, live to eat.
Live to eat. Well, God, I just, this is one thing I did right is God has given me power over my food choices. I'm supposed to consume food, not let food consume me. And once you learn that, you know, women, years ago, my husband said to me, he goes, you think about food all the time. I go, well, who else is going to think about it? I've got to go shopping. I have to make sure everything's, you know, cooked. So, of course, the first thing I think about in the morning is what are we having for lunches and for dinner? You know, so women, I think, almost have it a little bit. Sometimes a little bit harder if they are the ones that are in charge of that.
And my wife's the same way. She'll be thinking of the meal through the whole week.
Yes.
You know, so she'll get up like this morning. She gets up and she's like, okay, what am I doing for breakfast? And what am I doing?
That's right.
And she will spend, like you said, she will spend tomorrow or Sunday.
Prepping.
I don't know which day. It's food prepping.
Yep.
And tomorrow is Sunday.
Okay.
Just to let you know.
Okay. I got my days. I got up this morning and thought it was Sunday.
Were you going to church?
Yeah. Yeah, I was. I actually got dressed to go to church. She was like, what are you doing? I was like, oh, whoops. Yeah. So she'll do that. And she'll have everything in portion sizes in the refrigerator. So I don't have to think about it.
Yeah.
I just grab a thing of Tupperware with whatever she made. And that's
John,
my portion.
Then I want you to remove some weight.
I'm trying.
Amen.
For that.
It's really important.
Amen. I'm glad she didn't point. Go ahead, Bonnie.
I'll be pointing to you too, Mister.
People who are struggling, they need our prayers.
Oh, definitely.
Amen. Yeah.
And you need to pray. Need to pray about it too, because Jesus is going to help you get through this.
Yep.
I know I didn't get this far on my own, and I know that it was God who was been with me every single day, single moment.
Amen. Well, Bonnie, I believe we got maybe another caller on the line.
We do.
Okay. So thank you so much,
thank
man.
Thank you for sharing, Bonnie.
We're praying for you. We'll continue to pray for you. You're a great example.
Yes, absolutely. I'm looking forward to doing
push-ups again. It's not even funny.
Thank you, Bonnie. Have a great day.
Tell Dwayne I said hi.
Bye, Bonnie.
Thank you. I will.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Good morning. Welcome to... Yep. Recovery Radio
hasn't put him on hold yet.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Well,
all right. So, I mean, there's a great example.
She's still talking to him.
There's a great example of someone that is determined
to
not give in to a situation that you could begin to either feel sorry for yourself, you know, poor me, and now, you know, I'm right now with this, I'm in a wheelchair, so I'm really not, you know.
Yeah.
So you listen, God knows the whole situation.
Mm-hmm.
And,
that's right.
And again, with some accountability, you can get through anything with God.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, yeah.
Right? And so why change your good habits because of a difficult situation?
That's right.
And many people do.
That's right.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
It's easier.
That's right.
They give up.
Yep, that's right. That's exactly right.
She was inspirational. I mean, she didn't even do this on surgery. She did this on her own.
Yes.
Right. 200 pounds. 200 my goodness.
Pounds. Yeah.
I mean, she's incredible.
Yes. Yeah. So, you know, there's the example. If Bonnie can do it, and I like the personal example, that's why we bring people to testimonies, you know, here at the radio program. And callers like you that give us that inspiration to say, man, if she can do it, I can do it. There is hope.
Right.
And you just have to work the program, as they say, in a way. And that's really important.
Yeah.
And listen, it's not easy.
No.
You got to be disciplined. You know, it's
and
not
like. And especially, you know, this really disturbs me. And like what she was saying, that people are going, oh, you can have lasagna. Oh, you can have that. You can have this.
Yeah.
There are so many people out there that will try. You got to have this. I made this. I made this for you.
Yeah.
You know, and it's when somebody says no, thank you, the person should just say, okay.
Yeah.
You know, and let it go, because we struggle, especially with people that have, like myself, a food addiction, you know. Don't force it on me. If I say no, I mean no.
Yeah.
And people don't want to hurt anybody's feelings.
Sure.
Yeah.
But you got to. I mean, you've got to take charge of your health. Nobody else is going to. It's you and how you feel.
And it's your life.
It's your life.
I mean, you have the capability of living a healthy, long life.
Absolutely.
And how many of us shorten that because of our own bad habits, right?
Oh, yeah.
And then we get less mobile and less physical.
That's right.
Yeah.
And then we have more ailments or more challenges. And what do? We just cover that up like with a blanket. I'll be fine. I'm going to get through this. No, you're not. You're not, unless you begin to make some changes. And I love the wording, move a muscle. Make a change. And when you begin to do that, you know, ask for help. Ask God for help, some guidance, some prayers, people to come into your life, like a Patty, who I have been there and done that. And they can encourage you, and you can talk about, maybe go shopping with. Maybe many of you don't know how to shop healthy because, you know, I walk in, I don't have a bag of chips. I grab a bag of chips because I'm out of chips. So, and then I'll go up the other aisle, and then I grab a few more things, and a guacamole dip. And now, you know, I'm already thinking, okay, there's a football game on, so I've got this, and this.
Your little weenies, huh?
And
I'm sitting
in front of the TV, and I've eaten half a bag of chips, salsa, cheese dip. I've got to have five varieties.
Of course.
And I'm like,
because you couldn't make a decision.
And I'm stuffed.
Yeah.
And then my wife will say, so now what are we going to have for dinner? Because I do the cooking and the shopping. And I'm like, oh, yeah, okay, dinner. Let me throw something on. So now, you know, you're exactly right. Portions are, and it's difficult, Patty. Yeah.
It's really
hard. Yeah.
But you know what? Okay, God is number one for sure. God is number one. But when it comes to our health, we should be number one.
Amen. Exactly.
Amen. Patty, we've had our producer sent me a text. Would you be willing to come back next week? The phone has blown up.
Yep.
There are so many people. We've got emails. We've got texts. Pat said that she is taking on so many phone calls, questions.
The phone's been ringing off the
hook. It is off the hook.
I got chills.
People want to.
I
do
got
too.
Chills.
I do too. People want to hear more. This is a big This is a big challenge.
It is.
So many people.
It's like
millions
Bonnie said,
and millions of people.
With people that have other addictions like drugs and alcohol, smoking and all that.
Yeah.
You don't need any of that to survive.
Right. Exactly.
No. You need the food to survive. You have to eat.
Right. Right.
Will you come back next Saturday for us?
Sure.
Oh, beautiful.
Awesome.
Yay. Maybe you'll even sing a song.
I'll sing with you. Val will make me come back.
Oh, listen, Val already texted me, and she said, I'm glad that you realized, and you're out of denial, that I can't sing. So I love you, Val.
And, good going, Val.
Hey, John, we're running out of time real quick.
Okay.
So let's wrap this up.
All right. Yeah, so shout out to our sponsors here. We have Just Garage Doors, now hiring. They're located at 2555 North Kiowa Boulevard, Suite 100, by phone 928-855-6331. We also have Sunshine RV, experience sales and service at its best with Kyle and the gang, located at 2995 Maricopa Avenue. And they also have a new Northside location on Highway 95 near Dillard's at The Shops. You can also reach them on the web at sunshinerv.com or by phone 928-855-6648. We also have ServPro of Lake Havasu City, Bullhead City, and Kingman. Family-owned and operated residential and commercial restoration and cleaning services located at 2775 Kiowa Boulevard North. By phone 928-855-9124 or on the web at ServPro Lake Havasu City, Bullhead City, Kingman.com. That is a long address.
Yes, it is.
Okay. And also a shout out to Ace Pest Control, serving the Lake Havasu area for over 20 years with termite, pest, and weed control. By phone 928-680-0988 or on the web at acepestcontrolaz.com.
And again, our website, recoverryradiolhc.com. You can watch past shows and get information, all kinds of information. John, our closing prayer today.
That's okay. Bow your heads with me. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the victories reached, and we ask that you help us treat the bodies you gave us with the respect they deserve. We thank you for health. We thank you for recovery. We thank you for life. Help us to be more like you and seek your will in everything we do. We give you all the glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' precious name, amen.
Amen. Well, thank you, Patty. We're so excited. We'll see you next week. Hey, we will see you on the radio. Remember, we're better together. Keep coming back. I'm your host, Mike. We love you, and we'll see you next week. Have a great week.
Goodbye from now from Recovery Radio, where we have hope for you.